What's the best workout to get rid of liver fat? Fatty liver is bad news. It can cause insulin resistance, diabetes, and it affects one in every three adults. But here's the good news. Working out can reverse it. We've known for a long time that weight loss in general is dynamite for fatty liver. But researchers discovered something remarkable. Exercise alone can reduce liver fat, even if your weight stays the same. In one study, overweight adults worked out on a stationary bike 3 times a week. No diet change, no weight loss, and their liver fat dropped by 21%. So it can work even without diet. Now, if you add the diet on top of the workout, then the effect is even more powerful. One review put together 8 studies, and they concluded that exercise can reduce liver fat by about 30%. But when you combine exercise and diet, then the effect is up to 50% reduction in liver fat. In this case, the studies they looked at reduced the fat in the diet and also the glycemic index of foods, but a number of different diets have been shown to work for weight loss and to reduce liver fat. Okay, so working out is great. What's better, cardio or weights? Both are really good. Both have been shown to work. If I had to choose, I'd lean towards the cardio. So brisk walking or cycling or jogging, it has a slight edge in studies, not a large difference. In fact, there's a number of trials that find them to be about equally effective. So pick the one you can do consistently. One advantage of resistance training, so lifting weights or body weight circuits or resistance bands, is the level of intensity and the energy expended tends to be lower than cardio. So resistance training might be a better option for people with lower cardiorespiratory fitness or who have some limitation, who can't tolerate cardio for some reason, an injury or something like that. Also, resistance training builds a little bit of muscle, which is good for blood sugar control. It helps control blood sugar a little better. So of course, ideally, you want to do both if you can, cardio and some resistance training. And we're going to come back to how to incorporate both into your week. There's a study that suggested that cardio might be more effective in males to lose liver fat and resistance training more effective in females. It's not very strong evidence. It's kind of a suggestion in one study, but I thought it was an interesting finding because it kind of goes against the natural tendency of most people. Okay, so what's the most effective workout structure? What would it look like? Moderate to vigorous cardio, 60 to 75% of maximum heart rate, 30 to 45 minute sessions, at least 3 times a week. That consistently reduces liver fat in studies. In one randomized trial, folks had a lot of liver fat and they were put on a workout program. And by the end, 50%, half of them, no longer had a lot of liver fat. But in the group that exercised at least 3 times a week, that number was 71%. So the majority of participants really made a dent in their liver fat. So the number of weekly sessions matters, and that 3 a week is a helpful cutoff. So the good news is you don't need to run a marathon. You don't need to lose 100 pounds to start seeing results. Just find a way to move consistently. Okay, how long do I have to do this for before I see some results? Often after 1 month, we start seeing benefits, and after 3 months, substantial changes. Many trials last for 12 weeks, so 3 months, and by then, it's pretty common to see 20, 30% drop in liver fat with workout programs. Other workouts that have also been shown to work, body weight exercises, I mentioned it earlier. So things like squats and push-ups have been shown to effectively reduce liver fat. HIIT, high intensity interval training, which is pretty popular. Most people are familiar with it. It alternates bursts of high intensity activity with recovery periods of low intensity, and it also works. One small trial put overweight participants with fatty liver on a HIIT program for 3 months. The workout consisted of a 30 to 40 minute session of cycling 3 times a week. Specifically, it was a 5 minute warm up and then 5 cycles of high intensity cycling for 2 to 4 minutes, interspersed with 3 minutes of recovery, and then a 3 minute cool down at the end. By the end of the 3 months, they had lost 27% of their liver fat, which is very respectable. So here's what a sample week might look like to blast that liver fat. Monday, Wednesday, Friday, cardio. It could be a 40 minute brisk walk or a jog or a HIIT session. So for example, cycling on an exercise bike, 4 cycles of 4 minutes going hard and then 3 minutes going easy, recovery. Tuesday, Saturday, resistance training. For example, you can do upper body one day, lower body the other. If you're more advanced, you can do 3 days of resistance training, and then Thursday and Sunday, rest days. So exercise is very powerful, even if the diet is kept constant. Now, you can easily lose the benefits of exercise if the diet goes crazy. So you want to combine those workouts with a healthy diet. Unprocessed fruits and vegetables, whole grains, lean protein, and try to minimize the added sugars and the alcohol, which are pretty tough on the liver. What about intermittent fasting? Can that help with your liver health? We covered that in this previous video, so check it out, and I'll see you in there.